Hello, I'm Dr. Ross Walker and welcome to The Checkup. I'd like to talk today about the genetic causes of clotting. About 1% of people are born with one of these abnormalities. The commonest one is a thing called factor V laden. Now, factor V is part of the clotting system, and if you have this factor V laden abnormality, it makes your blood thicker and more predisposed to clotting. Another one is what we call prothrombin complex. There's a few more serious ones where antithrombin 3 deficiency, protein S, protein C deficiency, and another particularly common cause of clotting is what we call the anti-cardiolipin antibody syndrome. Now, what happens with all of this is people who have these clotting abnormalities who are then immobilized for any reason. They might have had a knee operation, or they could have been sitting in a plane for 5, 6, 7, 8, 12 hours. Their blood can thicken and they can form a clot. Now, in the veins and the atria of the heart, there is low flow, so it's easy to form a clot in those environments and you need stronger blood thinning. Whereas in the arteries under higher pressure, you don't need as strong a blood thinner. So that's why if someone's had a stent or a heart attack, we give them low dose aspirin, which is a mid-range blood thinner. But if they have a clot in their veins, or have a clot in their lungs, or a clot in the atrium, or they've had a mechanical heart valve, they need the stronger drug warfarin to actually thin their blood down. Now, as we age, I'll give you an example. I saw a patient today who was in his 70s and had spinal surgery, but soon after the spinal surgery, developed a huge clot in his left leg, but he'd never had clotting before. But it was the prolonged immobilization of the spinal surgery, not the fact that he had one of these genetic clotting abnormalities, that caused his particular clot. So any prolonged immobilization, when women use the oral contraceptive pill, and if they've got a genetic abnormality, that can bring out clotting. Certainly, there's been cases of stroke seen in this situation. But when women start hormone replacement therapy with an estrogen component, that also can increase their risk for clotting as well. So, and as we get older, other chronic diseases such as cancer and other things such as that, autoimmune disease, can increase your risk for clotting. So does everyone have to go onto warfarin if they have one of these venous clots? No, because these days we have newer anticoagulant agents that don't require all the blood tests, they don't require the careful watching of what you eat and what you drink and what pills you take. These drugs you take once or twice a day, depending on which drug it is. They're highly effective, probably a little bit more effective than warfarin. But let me say, if you've had a mechanical valve put in your heart, there's still no evidence that these drugs work better than warfarin, so you're still stuck with warfarin in that situation. So the point about this is that 1% of people are clotters and probably 1% are bleeders, but most of us are in the middle without all of this. But if you are a clotter, you certainly need more intensive therapy. That's The Checkup. We'll talk more next week.